Welcome to the CT WiZ Public Portal. This portal can be used by patients and legal guardians to access official immunization records. It can be used to access children's immunization records that may be needed for school, camp, or daycare. It can also be used to access adult immunization records that may be needed for college, employment, or travel. Co-workers Carmen and Randall will show us how the CT WiZ Public Portal is able to help them get official immunization records electronically within minutes. All names and records in this video are fictitious.
Hey Carmen. I just saw the reminder email from HR about submitting our COVID-19 vaccination records, but I can't find my vaccination card, and I'm not even sure what the clinic name was to call anyone. How were you able to submit your proof so fast?
Well, recently, I had forgotten to request my daughter Cam's vaccination records from her pediatrician, and she needed them for school. My husband let me know that the Connecticut Department of Public Health offers a free electronic service called the CT WiZ Public Portal, where you can enter your information and download your official immunization records immediately.
That sounds great, but how do I know that it's secure? It's online, after all.
CT WiZ Public Portal uses a two-factor authentication to make sure that the record comes up only for the patient or a parent or guardian for a minor child. When you search for your information, you will make sure to exactly match your information as it was given to your most recent vaccination provider, including the mobile phone number or email address given. Only if an exact match is found in CT WiZ will a verification code get sent to the mobile phone or email address given to that provider. After you receive the verification code and enter it into the CT WiZ Public Portal, that's when you can access your official immunization record.
So the demographic information and communication method I gave at the clinic is what I'll use to retrieve my record.
Exactly. Let me show you the portal. The portal is designed to be used on a personal computer or cell phone. On the DPH Public Portal webpage, you can click the button on the page or access the CT WiZ Public Portal by going to ct.dph.gov/ct-wiz_public/login/public-portal.asbx. The portal works with Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, or Mozilla Firefox. Go ahead and pull it up on your cell phone, but make sure you are not using any shared or public Wi-Fi network since we are accessing your personal information in the portal.
It is asking me to enter my first and last name, date of birth, and gender.
Yes, your first and last name, date of birth, and gender all need to be entered exactly like it is at the provider you were most recently vaccinated at, or you will receive an error message that the record was not able to be found.
I see a drop-down asking, what is your relationship to the patient? As an adult, I'm going to select, I am the patient.
That's correct. Next, you'll select how you would like to receive a code to access your immunization records. Pick mobile phone or email, and then go ahead and click the search button.
I'm going to select mobile phone, because I know the clinic had my cell phone number, because I remember getting a reminder text before my appointment. I'm entering my cell phone number now. I clicked search, and I got a message stating there was not a record matching the search criteria supplied.
Did you give them a nickname instead of your legal name? I know I've heard you introduce yourself as Randy before. If you try multiple times with information that does not match your record in the system, you will get an error message that we have exceeded your number of searches. If that happens, you can just wait and try again later. If you continue to get the message after trying your full name and any nicknames, then you can complete a help desk ticket at dph-cthelpdesk.ct.gov/ticket or call 860-509-7929, and the Connecticut DPH staff will make any needed updates to your record so that you can try the portal again. Remember that your communication information provided also has to be a match to what your most recent vaccination provider has on file.
Of course, let me try Randy instead. It found a match, so now I should click Request Code to access immunization record.
Yes, it is very important that you click that button to have the verification code sent to you. This is the two-factor authentication I mentioned to you.
I just got the access code. Now, I will enter the verification code and click Verify.
Look at how quickly your record came up. You can either select Download Full Record or Download COVID-19 Record in the upper right corner of the screen to download the immunization record to your device, and then you can print it or save it for your proof. Remember, this is an official immunization record, so make sure you always keep your health information in a private and secure location.
This is great, but I only see my COVID-19 vaccination. Shouldn't this also show me the flu shot I got? Or all those vaccines I had to get when I traveled overseas a couple years ago?
The records will only include data reported to and entered into CT WiZ. Some records that may not be included are immunizations received outside of Connecticut and childhood immunizations for people who are now adults. CT WiZ has a record of your COVID-19 vaccinations because you received them in Connecticut.
Okay, that makes sense. I can always complete a help desk ticket or call the DPH immunization program if I thought something was incomplete, right?
Yes, if you have questions regarding a record not being complete, create a help desk ticket at dph-cthelpdesk.ct.gov/ticket or call 860-509-7929.
Thank you so much for your help, Carmen. I'm going to submit this to HR immediately. I'm going to let my wife know too, both for her employer requirements and the kids start school this week. I know this is going to make completing the paperwork much faster for us.